Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 15.3. In this section we will see double integrals in polar coordinates. Suppose that we want to evaluate a double integral of a function of two variables over the region R, where R is one of the regions shown in this figure. The first one is an example of a disk. It is called a disk and its equation is given by in this like this, x square plus y square, for example, for this one, is given by less than or equal to 1. Namely, the disk contains every point in the circle in this area. Okay. And the second one is called washer. So we have a disk here, a disk, and its equation is stated in this form. And the second is called a washer. So the region is between two circles, you can see. The inner one is x square plus y square is equal to 1. Actually, it is the upper circle. And the second one is given as x square plus y square is equal to 4. And the region will be between these upper circles, or can be exact circle, the total circle. The important thing is to describe the regions as a disk and a washer, like this one. Okay. So in this case, the description of the region in terms of rectangular coordinates is rather complicated. But R is easily described using polar coordinates. So the polar coordinates are stated as r theta of a point are related to the rectangular coordinates xy by the equations written here. For example, when we take any point in the xy coordinate system stated as xy, so we can transform this point into the polar coordinates as r theta using the equations written here. The equations are obtained by constructing the perpendicular triangle, you can see. We can construct these equations for every point in the xy coordinate system. Therefore, every point given as given according to the rectangular coordinates can be written as in the polar coordinates. So first we sketch a vertical line to the x-axis, which is represented by the variable y, because this is the second component of the point generally. And then we know the horizontal distance, which is the first component of the point, x, which is written as x. And then from the origin to the point we sketch another line, which is called the hypotenuse of the perpendicular triangle, which is stated as r. And from here we use the identities of the trigonometric functions. You know, cosine theta is the neighborhood edge over the hypotenuse, namely cosine theta from here is equal to x over r. And you know, sine theta is equal to the division of the opposite edge over the hypotenuse, namely y over r. So from here we obtain x is equal to r times cosine theta and y is equal to r times sine theta. And when we take the square of them and by adding them, we get x square plus y square is equal to r square, because we have r square cosine square theta and plus r square sine square theta. And from here we obtain r square times cosine square plus sine square, which is equal to 1. Therefore we obtain r square. So this is written as r square is equal to x square plus y square. Using these equations, every point can be written in polar coordinates. And to take the double integral of functions of two variables over the region, such that the region is one of them, can be disk or a washer, So we write in place of x and y r times cosine theta and r times sine theta. And the formula to see the function in polar coordinates is written here. If we want to take the integral of this function, if f is continuous on a polar rectangle r, given by r is between two numbers a and b, and theta is between two angles alpha and beta, where beta minus alpha is between 0 and 2 pi. Namely, we take a tour around the circle or a disk once, therefore we write b minus beta minus alpha is less than or equal to 2 pi. So the double integral of the function of two variables over the region r is equal to f r times cosine theta. Instead of x, we write its polar coordinate form, and y is equal to r times sine theta times r. You should be careful for the additional factor r. You should remember always the factor r when we evaluate the double integral in polar coordinates. The inner integral will be respect to will the inner integral will be with respect to r, and the outer integral will be with respect to the angle theta. Using this formula, easily we can find the integral of functions of two variables in polar coordinates if we take the integral over the polar region r. For the next example, we use the trigonometric identity, which is called the half angle formula. Cosine 2 theta is equal to 1 minus 2 times sine square theta, you know. Or you can write cosine square theta minus sine square theta. Okay. So evaluate the integral of the function, which is given as 3 times x plus 4 times y square over the region R, where R is the region in the upper half plane bounded by the circles x square plus y square is equal to 1 and x square plus y square is equal to 4. Okay, you can see the region is between two circles, which means we have the second case here. It is called washer. So, and this is the shape of the region in the xy coordinate system. Region is between the circles x square plus y square is equal to 1, and the outer circle is x square plus y square is equal to 4. Since we have upper circles here, upper half circles, so theta will be between 0 and pi, because from here we can have the angle until here, which is pi. Okay, therefore theta will be change between 0 and pi, and r represents the radius of the circles. The radius of the inner one is 1, and the radius of the outer one is 2 from here. Therefore, r will be between 1 and 2. They represent the limit points of the integrals. So after determining the lower limit and upper limits of the integrals, easily we can find the double integral of the function. It is the half ring or washer in this figure you see in polar coordinates, and it is given by these inequalities. R is between 1 and 2 and theta is between 0 and pi. Therefore, using the formula written here, we write the outer integral will be, you know, with respect to the angle. Therefore, we write the limit points of the angle, which are 0 and pi, and the limit points of the radius are 1 and 2. And instead of x, we write r times cosine theta, you see, and y is r times sine theta. Therefore, y square becomes r squared times sine squared theta. And from the formula we have always the additional factor r, you see. And from here, first we take the integral of this function with respect to r, with respect to r. Multiplying the this term by r, we get 3r squared cosine theta plus 4r to the power 3 times sine squared theta. And with respect to r, the integral of the first term, which means cosine theta, is a constant like the number 3. So we have the integral of r square, which is r cube over 3, and we have another 3 in the numerator. By removing them, we have just r to the power 3 times the constant, which is cosine theta. Similarly, the integral of 4 times r to the power 3 is r to the power 4, and sine square theta is a constant with respect to r. And writing the limit points of the inner variable, we obtain 7 times cosine theta plus 15 times sine square theta. And we know already the integral of the first term, you know, the integral can be distributed over the addition. Therefore, we can take the integral of each term separately, written here. The integral of cosine theta is sine theta, you know, 7 times sine theta. And to take the integral of sine square theta, we use the trigonometric identity written here to get rid of the second power for the trigonometric function. So instead of sine square theta, using this formula, actually we have here sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cosine 2 theta over 2. From here, writing this, we have over 2, which is written as 15 over 2, and we have 1 minus cosine 2 theta, which is the numerator written here. And then 15 over 2 is a constant. The integral of 1 is theta. Now we take the integral with respect to the angle theta. So the integral of 1 will be theta, and we have the factor, which is 15 over 2, minus the integral of cosine theta is equal to sine 2 theta over 2. Therefore, we have another 2 in the denominator, so the denominator becomes 4, so 15 over 4 times sine 2 theta from 0 to pi, and writing them for theta, we get 15 pi over 2. Okay, easily we can find the integral of the function over the region which is between two circles. If we use directly the rectangular coordinates, it will be very hard. The second example, find the volume of the solid bounded by the plane z is equal to 0 and the paraboloid z is equal to 1 minus x squared minus y squared. First, we should determine the region to find the volume of the solid. You know, the volume of the solid represents the double integral actually. To find the volume of the solid, we take the double integral of the function, which is the paraboloid actually. Z is equal to 1 minus x squared minus y squared. So we should determine the region first. The region is actually the projection of the paraboloid onto the xy plane. Therefore, to get the region, we should find the intersection of the plane z is equal to 0, which is actually the xy plane, and the paraboloid z is equal to 1 minus x squared minus y squared. Actually, we take the projection of this paraboloid onto the xy plane by intersecting them. So we put z is equal to 0 in the equation of the paraboloid, and when we write 0 for z, we get writing these ones into the left hand side. So we get x squared plus y squared is equal to 1. This means that the plane intersects the parabolate. The plane z is equal to 0 intersects the parabolate in the circle x squared plus y squared is equal to 1. So the solid lies under the parabolate. You can see the graph of the parabolate here. And above the circular disk given by x squared plus y squared is less than or equal to 1. First we get the intersection of the plane, which is the xy plane, by the parabolate, which is the circle you see. And when we take the projection of all the points on the parabolate onto the xy plane, so we get a disk, you see. We get a disk. Therefore, the solid will be under the parabolate above the circular disk, which means actually the first case here. We have the a disk given here graphically, and the circle is given by x squared plus y squared is equal to 1, and we take a total tour around the circle once. Therefore, namely from this point, which is the starting point, we circle it along the circle until again here. Okay, so the angle for this way, for this path, will be 2 pi at most. Therefore, theta will be 0 and will be between 0 and 2 pi. So since we have a disk, so the radius will be 0 and 1. 1 is obtained by using the radius of the circle. Radius is here is equal to 1. Therefore, r is between 0 and 1, and theta is between 0 and 2 pi. So after determining the limit points of the polar coordinates, so now we can use the formula for obtaining the volume of the solid. So we take the integral actually of the function, which is given as 1 minus x squared minus y squared, and we use the polar coordinates. Therefore, instead of minus, namely we can write minus x squared plus y squared for the function, and we know x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Therefore, instead of x squared plus y squared, we write r squared. So the volume of the solid is the double integral of the parabolate, 1 minus x squared minus y squared, which means 1 minus r squared times the additional factor r dr d theta. The order is fixed always. And the limit points of the radius is 0 and 1. The limit points of the angle are 0 and 2 pi. So the integral of 1 minus r squared is equal to r minus, first we multiply this term by r, so we get r minus r to the power 3, and it's integral with respect to r is equal to, namely we have here 0 from 0 to 2 pi. The integral of r is equal to r squared over 2 minus the integral of r to the power 3 is r to the power 4 over 4 from 0 to 1 d theta. Okay, so it is equal to writing the limit points instead of r. We obtain the integral from 0 to 2 pi with respect to theta, which is the angle. Writing 1, we get 1 over 2 minus 1 over 4 becomes 1 over 4. When we write 0, we get 0. So therefore, we have just 1 over 4. And from here, the integral of 1 over 4 is equal to 1 over 4 theta, from 0 to 2 pi. So from here we obtain, writing the limit points, pi over 2. Okay, the volume of the solid above the circular disk and under the parabolate is pi over 2. Thank you very much.